Welcome to Life Talks with Stephen Marshall.
Connected is directed. Psalm 119 is a famous chapter in the Bible for two reasons. It is the longest chapter with 176 verses, and almost every verse mentions God's word in some way. This is significant because God's word is active, powerful, and eternally unchanging. The word is the true light, as it clearly says in John 1. So when we read, investigate, and meditate on scripture, we are actually connecting to God, his power, his illuminating truth. Isn't that exciting? There is a familiar verse in Psalm 119, verse 105 that says, quote, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path," end quote. We live at a time when people are frantic for direction. We face trials and terrors of things humanity has not dealt with before, and yet it's the same old ultimate fear, the fear of darkness and dying. No one wants the light to go out on life, and yet when people feel like all light is gone, all hope is gone, they turn to death as a final solution. Strange the way darkness seduces the mind toward death. Here's an even stranger fact. Darkness doesn't really even exist. Darkness is not the opposite of light, but rather it is the absence of light. You cannot make a room darker by adding more darkness to it, because darkness does not exist. You have to remove more light to make a room darker. There is no theoretical limit to how luminous and bright light can be. Reminds you of God's character and glory, doesn't it? 1 John 1:5, quote, "And this is the message which we have heard from him and now are reporting to you. God is light, and there is no darkness in him at all," end quote. God is light. God is love. God is life. When you speak the truth out like this, it's quite awe-inspiring to consciously realize that God is the complete source of all we desperately need. Our greatest fears, therefore, are not of death, but of the absence of life. Darkness is not our real problem. It's the lack of his light, his glory. Once upon a time in a hotel room in Mexico, I was headed from the bed to the bathroom in the dark and ran full force into the edge of the open door. I broke my toe and blackened my eye. Without light, I was not directed. I lacked guidance and suffered for it. Oh, did I ever suffer from head to toe. Now, considering the evil and darkness of our times, look at Psalm 119, verse 105 again. Quote, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path," end quote. God's word is both the lamp and the light. That tells us that his word is the producer and the product. No wonder it says in verse 11 of the same chapter, quote, "Your word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you," end quote. We have no power over sin or darkness in ourselves. But if we have the lamp that produces the light, victory is ours. Where the light is, it dominates the darkness instantly. Doesn't matter if it's a bedroom, a runway, a mine shaft, or inside your soul. Light deals with darkness the same every time. Fear seems so real, but it's really the absence of faith. Love casts it out instantly, but God's love is light and fear is just another form of darkness. Does this sound familiar? What am I going to do? Where should I go? Who do I turn to? Who can I trust? Why is this happening to me? Am I the only one? God's word is the ultimate lamp producing the light of life. Why do we keep returning to God's word? To get it in our heart on the inside, because it produces light. Light is a solution to the darkness, the depression, sin, and sadness. Yes, even death. You can't fake being directed. You either have the true light or you don't. Quit trying to squint through the darkness, groping cautiously into the pitch black, and turn on the light of God. How? Get connected by faith to God's word. Get directed by faith with God's word. When you're connected, you are directed. All right, let's pray the word. God, we receive your word into our heart and we hold on to it. Your word is the lamp for our feet, our immediate steps. Your word is the light to our path, our future plans. We don't just quickly flash the light on and off expecting to somehow remember which is the right way. You want us walking confidently and boldly into the future. Your word tells us that without a vision, people perish. You want us having 2020 spiritual vision so we don't perish. Thank you for the privilege of having your light and being a light in this world. Help us now to shine so others can get to know you. Amen. I want you to know that we care about you here at All Nations Church. If you're feeling disconnected, let us help you. We have wonderful ministers that would love to reach out and phone you, pray with you, and encourage you. Don't let the darkness of isolation overpower you. Everything can change in an instant. So reach out to us on our website at allnationschurch.ca and ask for a call. We want to help you. God loves you, and we care about you.